Hi guys, welcome to another one of my tutorial videos. This time it's actually on a value study painting that I did. But before I go on, I would like to let you guys know that this is actually something that I learned from an online art school called Schoolism. There's one thing they're doing cool right now is that for a $200 subscription, you basically get all their videos. It's just that you don't get to hand in homework and no feedback on your study that you do. But basically, you get to look at all their courses video, which is pretty cool, and which I'm doing right now, and I really enjoy it. So this is something that I'm doing right now with them, and I'm learning a lot actually. So one of their assignments was to do a value study. So for the value study, basically, you start off with just three shades: a highlight, a midtone, and a dark tone. And the rest of the spectrums fall in between those three tones. So basically, for the homework that we were doing, that we just actually start off with three tones like that. The course that I'm going through right now on Schoolism, it's actually called Painting with Light and Color, and the two instructors are Daisuke Tatsumi and Robert Kondo, which is a really, really good course. One thing I learned about drawing through my own practice and this course is that how important is it to learn to see value in order to be a good painter in any style that you want to be, no matter it's a classical or concept art, anime, comic. Value is something that you need to understand, and it's a fundamental skill that you need. And one interesting thing that I learned is that how when you are looking at the objects that you are drawing, how squinting your eyes actually help you. When you squint your eyes, you actually see the highlights better, you see the shadow better, the tones actually separates better for you. And you can have a clear structure for how to tackle what you are drawing. When you paint just in value itself, you learn how lights interact with other stuff. You learn that some of the stuff might look lighter because of the saturation, but it's actually not lighter. It's just the colors that's changing how your eye perceives the darkness and the or the lightness of the object. So I do think this is a worthwhile thing for you to try and practice if you are seriously about getting good at painting. And as you can see right now, I'm just laying out the big shapes. I'm laying out all the shadows, all the lights. This is one thing that actually I learned from them from painting, that you can start off with just pure shapes. And also, my Camtasia is doing this weird thing where you can see me actually just lassoing and putting in the paint bucket, right? But you also see this weird brush tool and lasso tool moving around, which isn't doing anything. That I call it, there's a phantom arrow there. So ignore that, and just concentrate me using the lasso tool and putting down the tones I see. I actually never started painting this way, lassoing shapes and then filling in with color and then just doing it with three tones. But it's really interesting, and it's something that I learned from them. I saw them doing it on their tutorial on their class videos, and so I really want to try out myself. I may not paint every time this way, but if I'm ever going to do another study, I'll probably do it this way again, because it does forces you to understand what you're looking at. It forces you to try to understand the light source better and how it's interacting with all the stuff around you, and that because something is a different color value, but they actually have the same level of brightness or darkness. I created one mannequin and I copy and paste two more. Then I start fixing the shape on the one on the far right so that it resemble more to the picture. And now I begin painting the mannequin. I think you guys can see how I see the three different spectrum of the light, the dark, the mid. I think everybody sees it differently. I don't think there's right or wrong. It's just how we perceive it. You probably see it differently from me. I don't think that's wrong. But I just think that you gotta understand the three highlight, mid-tone, and the dark. So for me, the wall, the red door, and the ground has a similar spectrum of mid-tones, and then everything else that's dark, being cast by shadow, I see it as the same spectrum of dark, and same thing with the light. I really hope that I'm making sense, that I'm not babbling on. I'm not that great of a teacher, and it's hard for me to explain what I see and why I do certain things. But I do hope you guys are getting something out of it. And the reason why I want to share this, because I'm learning so much through Schoolism, and I know a lot of people cannot afford that $200 for videos. And I think information should be free, knowledge should be free. It shouldn't be held against people who can afford it. So that's why I'm trying my best to share with you guys what I know. And hopefully that's good enough. When we take a picture of a scenery or of anything, it's usually different from the way that we actually see it. For this pair of pants right now, when I was at the mall, I remember where the light was hitting the pants were a little bit lighter than what I see in the picture, so actually make it lighter. I think we have to remember that it's actually good to draw outside, to draw in real life, to go to a coffee shop and just paint with your laptop. But actually, I don't have a laptop, so I have to do it this way. But if you do this way, right, try to remember what you see, pick out all the details, because pictures are never the same of what we see with our own eyes. I said it in my last tutorial on my Pokemon fan art that it's important to understand hard and soft edges on shadows and highlights. Depending on how you use these edges, right, either be hard or soft, that it actually tells the audience, tell the viewer what type of material it is. So when you draw from life, it is really important to study these highlights, to study the shadows and how it really gives you a feel of what the material is in the picture. I'm going to sound like a broken record, because from my last tutorial, I quite a few times mentioned that instead of painting like what other painters would do, where they would broadly do everything and then slowly go into details, sometimes I like to dive in right in the detail first. Say for this background, that's what I'm doing, right? I'm doing the details on three mannequins first. For me, I like doing it that way is just because I like to set and kind of like an anchor for the rest of the piece, so that everything follows it. The proportion, the shape, where other stuff goes, depends on the three on the anchor that I'm doing. I don't know is it the right way or the wrong way, but it works for me so far, and I do like it that way. So everybody draw differently, right? So I think it's the end result that's important. But even though everybody draw differently, understanding fundamentals are the same. Every one of us should understand anatomy, should understand color theory, should understand fundamental stuff like value studies. These are stuff that we all should understand in order to be a good painter. And right now I'm doing stuff the lazy way. That's why I like digital stuff, because I don't need to draw everything. As you saw with the pattern on the pants, right? I actually just copy and paste and then merge down the layers. So everything, it's a bit easier. I don't have to draw everything every single time, such as the mannequin, right? I did one, copy and paste two, and then modify the next two, modify the shape a bit. So I don't think it's the wrong way either. When you work at a game studio or even a animation studio, right? Sometimes it's more efficient that way. You don't have the luxury to draw everything every single time. If there's a way for you to do stuff quicker, just do it that way. The reason why I chose this scene was just because there was a lot of different material present. You have that really scratchy, rock-like brick wall, and then you have that really shiny floor, the plastic on the mannequin, and the poster and paper. glossy paper. It's just a lot of stuff for me to look at, to understand, to study. That's why I actually chose this scene right now. I do think that if you guys have the money to spend on Skolasim, it's so worth it. I don't think I explain it well enough why we need to do these type of value studies. And the instructors, especially with this course, Painting with Light and Color, they have years and years of concept art experience. They know what they're talking about, and you learn so much more from them. I'm just giving you guys secondhand information. It's nowhere close to how good they are and what they explain. So if you guys do have the money to spend on, I think it's well worth it to check out these courses and practice what they teach. So I actually don't know why this happened every time I record myself painting. You see a ghost arrow, which is now working on the middle and the far right mannequin, but I'm actually working on the left pants, and then I'm moving on to the left feet, the toes, and the details on the feet. So ignore that phantom arrow on the far right mannequin. Look straight down onto the one on the left, far left, that I'm painting the highlights on the feet right now. So basically, the pens and the mannequins are done now, and I'm moving on to the rest of the background. And as I do the rest of the background, you notice that I use the lasso tool a lot actually. Whenever I need a straight line, I usually just use a lasso tool, giving that straight edge. It's easier than just freehanding it. It gives you a crisp straight line when you need one. So I'm actually using a Camtasia Studio to record myself draw. So I was wondering if anybody know this software and know why there's always a phantom error. Please let me know and leave a comment so I can fix this problem. Thank you. So here are examples of me using lasso tool for the straight lines. Right now, I'm working on the top of the wall where the red meets that picture frame on the top of the wall. A great way to do lines, straight lines on the tilt is to actually rotate your canvas. All you do is just press R and then you can rotate it. And once you do that, right, when you draw any line, straight line, it's still horizontal and or vertical. So when you return it, return your canvas to the normal position, these lines are actually tilted. Here again, ignore the brush phantom icon on the mannequin. Just see how I'm actually fixing the brick wall. And I'm sorry for here because actually my Camtasia crashed and I lost some footage of me finishing up the wall. But basically it was just having the lines and then painting the texture on it. I'm so sorry, but it crashed on me and I lost around maybe 20 minutes of footage of me finishing up the wall. Right now, I'm working on the power box thing. So for the detail in the middle, I'm just gonna do one, and then as you can see, I'm just copy and pasting for the rest of them. And now I'm working on the red door frame on the far left of the piece. And now I'm actually still working on the door on the far left side. I'm working a bit on the shadow of the posters being taped on the, I think, glass door, and then the steel metal frame around the glass door. So that's where I'm at right now. Now I'm working on the metal bottom of the glass door. I'm working on that right now. The door frame is mostly done now, and right now I'm concentrating on the posters. So, the posters are basically done, and I actually have fun doing these posters. I don't know why. So once the posters are done, we're off to the floor. And one thing important about the floor is that to give it that glossy, shiny plastic feel, we have to pay attention to the reflections. As you can see, once we put down the reflection from the mannequins, the ground automatically turned from a matte floor to a shiny plastic looking floor. The texture and the feel of the floor, it's mostly done. So now I'm just finishing up the way how it's tiled. So this piece is basically done. I hope you guys enjoy it. If you guys want more videos, tutorial videos from me, please like these videos so that I know you guys want more. And please go check out my website if you like my artwork. And also check out Skolasm. Their course subscription, it's really good. If you want to become a professional artist or simply just become a better artist, then check them out. I'll have the link on the bottom in the description. Thank you, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.